Greetings. What is the name of Allah? Let's take a look at a few scriptures. In Genesis 1:1, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. In English, the word is translated God. In Hebrew, the original word is Elohim. In a written Hebrew form, the word Elohim looks like this. In Arabic, the verse looks like this. In start creating Allah. And then the final text is the heavens and the earth. So it doesn't transliterate quite left to right, right to left, but you can understand in Arabic, the word for God is Allah, and it looks like this. So in Genesis 1:1, we can clearly see that the Arabic word of the general term God is Allah. Remember that God is a general word. It's a position like president, secretary, commander, father, husband, man. It is not the name of God. Let's look at another scripture example. Psalms 8. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is thy name. O Lord, our Lord. The word Lord appears twice in Psalms 8, verse 1. The first occurrence of Lord is Yahweh. The second occurrence of Lord is Adonai. Yahweh in Hebrew looks like that. That is also called the Tetragrammaton. Adonai is a different word in Hebrew. In English, we see that the word Lord may in Hebrew be either Yahweh or Adonai. Let's look at another example. And I appeared unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob by the name of God Almighty. But by my name Jehovah was I not known to them. But by my name Jehovah. So, by my name Jehovah. In Exodus 6:3, God reveals his name, Jehovah. Yahweh, the Tetragrammaton. It looks like this in Hebrew. In Arabic, the word for Jehovah is this. And I've looked it up online, and you know what's amazing? The websites that I found say that this is an unpronounceable word. It means nothing in Arabic. And that may be part of the confusion. If you speak Arabic and you expect every name to mean something, then I can understand why you're completely confused that God's name doesn't mean something in Arabic. You have a predisposition to assume in order for something to have a name, it must have a word that describes its meaning. If that's the case, then you have a really terrible problem on your hands, because God's name is this. Whatever this Arabic symbol is, however it's pronounced in your language, this is the name that God has revealed by himself, of himself. Remember, Allah means God, and this other symbol means Yahweh. And Yahweh is the name of God. So whatever this little symbol is down here, that means Yahweh. Allah is just the general name for God. Clearly, the name of God, Jehovah, or Yahweh, is not Allah. Therefore, Allah is not the proper name of God. So I ask you again, What is Allah's name? What is his personal name? What does he refer to himself as? If you call yourself Muslim, why do you worship a spirit whose name you do not know? Because Allah is not his name. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.